food and agriculture is responsible for between a quarter and a third of the world's greenhouse gas emissions. I'm really excited to be put forward for the Earthshot Advisory Panel. I'm a bit daunted, but also really excited. I think the prizes overall are amazing because they shift the focus from this is a problem to like really driving people to towards solutions, which is what we really need. I'm completely outcomes-based, so I just really want to see amazing solutions moving in the world. So my ideal outcome from the prize and being on the advisory panel is just to find really good solutions, and I have no doubts that there'll be amazing proposals. I think to protect nature, we need a combined approach of one, really shifting towards plant-based diets. That's the number one thing we need to do. I think the reality is we're not going to get there overnight. Over the next few decades, we will continue to eat meat in some sense. And therefore, I think we need this combined approach of one, reducing meat consumption and finding solutions that help us get there, but also trying to improve the way we do produce meat as we move along that pathway. So I don't think it's one or the other. I think we need both. We can't combat climate change without changing how we eat. So food and agriculture is responsible for between a quarter and a third of the world's greenhouse gas emissions. So to tackle climate change, there's no doubt we need to tackle energy and fossil fuels and industry, but we can't tackle it without also tackling food. So if we look at projected global greenhouse gas emissions from food over the next 80 or so years to 2100, if you only look at those emissions and we stopped using fossil fuels tomorrow, those emissions would take us past our 1.5 degree budget, so we'd go past our 1.5 degree target, and we'd use up most of our 2 degree budget. So the reality is we can't solve climate change without tackling energy, without tackling food. So we need to do both at the same time.